Good evening. My name is Tipanis Chachio. This is a series of lectures on quantum for beginners. It is intended for undergraduate students in physics, chemistry, or engineering who, for the first time, get to know quantum mechanics. The material in this course includes not only the general concepts of quantum mechanics, but also how to apply mathematics to make predictions, or use mathematics to derive various aspects of the theory. That means it is a good idea for you to have some background in calculus and differential equation. Much of the math involved will be self-contained, meaning that I will give a brief review of the math before applying it to the physics lessons. In the first chapter, the Schrödinger equation, we will be discussing six topics, namely introduction, classical mechanics versus quantum mechanics, probability, the meaning of wave function and particle in the box, quantum dots, and the roadmap for the entire course. A special type of synthetic particles can be created, 2 to 10 nanometer in diameter, made of cadmium selenide at the core of the particles, as shown under the electron microscope in figure A and B. These are usually called quantum dots. After creating millions upon millions of these quantum dots, we divide them into several groups based on the size of the particles, putting really small ones in their own test tube. The small, the medium, or the larger ones are all in their own containers. An interesting phenomenon happens. Upon excitation, the really small ones emit blue light. As the size grows larger, the color of the light changes from blue to green, and eventually to red. The fact that the color of these quantum dots depends on their size is a quantum effect, which is fascinating, and also in contradiction to the behavior of everyday objects that we see around us. Take brownie cake, for example. It does not matter if you cut the cake into small piece, medium piece, or a big piece of cake. They all have the same color because they are made of the same material, which in this case is chocolate. The quantum dots in the figure are made of the same material, which in this case is cadmium selenide. Nonetheless, they can emit different color simply because their sizes are different. In the first chapter, we will practice how to use the Schrödinger equation, which, by the way, is one of the most important equations in quantum mechanics, as an oversimplified model that explains the properties of these quantum dots. Let us begin with the introduction. Section 1.1 Introduction. Having studied introductory physics in the past, either in high school or during freshman year in college, we are familiar with objects that we can see with our naked eyes. For example, a box sliding on an inclined plane, a football moving in a projectile fashion in the air, wave on water surface, and even a planet orbiting around the sun. What makes it possible to explain these phenomena is the Newton's laws of motion, which falls into the category of classical mechanics. However, in the beginning of the 20th century, scientists began to probe experimentally into the nature of things in a very small scale, such as atoms and molecules. Tiny objects on the order of nanometer, which is 100,000 times smaller than the thickness of our hair. In 1909, Ernest Rutherford discovered that an atom is made of nucleus having positive charge densely packed at the center, and the electrons having negative charge distributed around the nucleus. The physical properties of these tiny systems, such as color, electrical and magnetic properties, even the vibration, cannot be fully understood using classical mechanics. In 1926, quantum mechanics was born, and it has spawned many inventions and technologies that we have seen until today. This theory is used to explain and predict physical properties of exotic material, with applications in the field of medication, communication, or alternative energy sources, and so on. Quantum mechanics is the subject of this class. Even though the purpose of this course is for the students to be able to comfortably combine mathematics with the ideas of quantum mechanics in order to understand at a deeper and more accurate level a physical phenomena, just like other undergraduate level quantum mechanics courses, the way we are approaching the subject will put a strong emphasis on the physics, which can be seen or visualized through diagrams or animations, along with the applications in the real world. It is our courageous aim that quantum mechanics in the eyes of the students will not just be mathematics technical terms written in an old, long-lost Latin alphabets, jumping back and forth with the equal sign in the middle, in the system of equation. To visualize the physics of quantum mechanics is not an easy task, as shown in the diagram. All things in the universe come in many sizes. Planets are on the order of million kilometers. Human body is about 1.5 to 1.8 meters. Human hair, although small, but we can still see it, is approximately 100 microns in diameter. But notice the domain of quantum mechanics, such as the thickness of a cell wall, which is 10 nanometers. A benzene molecule, 0.5 nanometer across. Hydrogen atom, down to a nucleus of an atom, where protons and neutrons are packed together with the size on the order of 1 divided by 100 million million meters. With such a small object, the quantum mechanics has been mostly useful. We hardly have a direct experience with these tiny systems. Because of this unfamiliarity, we are limited to the use of a model, mathematics, and sometimes an analogy as a tool to understand quantum mechanics. The use of analogies is a powerful technique to convey a complicated idea in physics, and it will be used frequently in this class. But we have to be very careful when using analogies, not to interpret them beyond the scope of the discussion. For example, if I am making an analogy comparing the attraction between an electron and a proton with the attraction between a man and a woman, with the keyword attraction as the focus of the discussion, that does not mean when the electron meets the proton, they produce another particle in the same way a man and a woman create a child. Such interpretation is beyond the scope of what is being discussed, which is focused at the attraction between the two particles. In many ways, the use of analogies to convey ideas in physics is like pointing a finger at the moon. The finger represents things we see around us every day that are being used as an analogy. The moon represents the concepts that the instructor is trying to get across. The students notice the finger, gaze their eyes along its direction, and finally see the moon. Once the moon is seen, the finger is meaningless. Trying to interpret the analogy beyond the scope of what is being discussed is like keep looking at the finger and never see the moon. In the next section, we will begin to see what quantum mechanics is by looking at what it is not. That is, trying to compare and contrast between classical mechanics and quantum mechanics, using the classical as a stepping stone to reach for the quantum. Until next time.